Hello, Sean Ben Mulligan. Good to see you, Sean. You're training now for January 31st.
Yeah, that's right.
It's going to be your pro debut. You've had two called off up to now, and I know you've been really disappointed, and it's not necessarily gone according to how you thought it would have gone. But hopefully now you can get this fight January 31st and get things kicking off now.
Yeah, it's been hard the last 6 months. I remember doing an interview back in like March, we were talking about having the first pro fight in June. And then that show got cancelled on a front row show. The bill got pulled. And then obviously got rescheduled for October for Pat's first show, Blackfast Promotions. And then a perfect image. I'm sparring in here. So yeah, it's been a bit of a bad past 6 months and not the best start to my career. But certainly going to put it right January the 31st. I'm in the gym now, sparring every day. I feel good now. And obviously it's, you know, like all my fans, and you're selling 100 and odd tickets, people are paying the hard earned money to come out and support you, and then you feel like you're letting people down, but what's happened, it just can't be helped. But I promise to put it right in January. Also, my sponsor, the White Room, who's putting a coach on, and you know, they've had to cancel the coach twice, so you know, I just can't wait to put it right now.
Yeah. You do sell quite a lot of tickets as well, don't you?
Yeah, I sell quite a lot. I've got like
good following as an amateur as well.
Yeah, that's it, yeah, but I always had quite a few in the amateurs, but hopefully now I'll get Prestwich and Whitefield behind me, you know, where I'm from. And just everywhere you want as much support as possible, don't you? But yeah, I'm hoping to definitely make a noise anyway on January the 31st, so
I mean, being gutted yourself about in all the training you've had to go through as well, but it's the other side of it as well, like running around selling the tickets, what you've had to do, and then having to give them all the money back, and you know, it's quite soul destroying a little bit, isn't it?
Of course, and you feel like you're letting people down, but obviously everyone understands, you know, it's out of my hands. But yeah, it's not like in the amateurs. If your fight gets cancelled, obviously you're gutted for the training, but it's the business side to it now as well, isn't it, in the pros, so.
Well, this is your living now as well. You need to be learning, don't you?
I need to get the ball rolling, get my career started.
Yeah, and your last fight, what, you had an injury in sparring. What happened there? Was you hit your eardrum?
Yeah, I was sparring in here. I started sparring on the Monday. Sparring in here was helpful. I took part of a shot. What, even a big shot, just took my balance away and torn the tympanic membrane in the left ear there. So that put me out for like 8 weeks. So obviously the fight in October got cancelled. I mean, I was hoping to maybe get out before Christmas on Steve Wood, my manager, one of his shows. But the doctor said it's not worth risking it, so I'm just waiting until January now.
And then on the Blackfast Promotion show, January 31st, last one was a good show, so hopefully this one will be all the better to have you on it as well.
Definitely, and obviously now I've seen it from a fan's perspective, so now I know what to expect, you know what I mean? And yeah, it's going to be a special night, I just can't wait for it now.
Well, your pro debut's long coming, you know, we're looking forward to seeing it, Ben, and God willing, everything goes well for January 31st.
Thank you, mate, thank you.